Hi everyone. Today's topic is what is the use of invocation count in test engine Selenium? Let me tell you. So, what is the use of invocation count in Selenium? Okay, to understand the uses of this feature in test engine, let's understand one scenario. Okay. Let's suppose you are having one scenario in which you have to execute that scenario 10 times. Okay, let's suppose I'm having one scenario, launch browser, okay, and open website and close browser. Okay, now in a loop you have to perform these three steps 10 times. Okay, you want to launch the browser, open website, close the browser 10 times. Okay, and for that you need to write the test cases 10 times, right? You have to write 10 test cases. Okay, that is kind of copy pasting a code, but instead of that you have one invocation count feature. Okay, but practically this feature can be used in data driven testing. Okay, in that you can just perform the steps again and you can use some increment variable in which you can just read the data from the Excel sheet or some external file. Okay, so I will show you invocation count uses with this example. Okay, so we have one scenario: launch browser, open website, and close browser. Okay, these are three steps in test case, and we have to perform these three test cases three steps in a test case 10 times. Okay, how can we do that? So let's launch Eclipse. Yeah, launch it. So I'm having one Selenium test engine configured project in Java. Okay. So click on this one and click on this one. So let me add one new class here. New class. Demo invocation count. Okay, click on finish. So I got one class here, demo invocation count. Okay, so I will create one test case here and public void demo test, and in this I will create one Chrome driver scenario. Okay, that driver driver is equal to new form driver. Okay, and so driver dot get, it will launch driveroverflow.com. okay, okay, so this is it, will close the browser. And okay, and let's suppose we have to set the system property to automate Chrome browser. Let me do that. Sorry, give me a second. System dot set property, and in key you have to pass the driver dot driver dot web driver dot chrome dot driver, and I'm having chrome driver dot exe in my sources folder. This is the file, right click on it, properties, this is the path. Okay, copy this path and paste it here. Okay, and put semicolon. So this is single scenario. Okay, let me run this scenario and show you it's working fine. So our file name was demo invocation count. Okay, let me run this file. So it will just launch the browser and close the browser single time. Okay, have a look. test is done one, pass one. Okay, now I have to convert this one test case to 10 times. Okay, I want to run the same scenario for 10 times. How can I do that? First, one option is just copy paste this scenario and paste here. Okay, this is not a good approach because this is kind of duplication in your code. Okay, so I will remove this and we will just use test and the attributes in location count. Okay, and is equal to 10. Okay, so if we execute this file again, so this scenario will be executed 10 times. Okay, it will launch the browser, open the website, close the browser. Let me show you. Run as test element. Have a look, it's closing the browser, launching the browser, closing the browser. It will do the same thing 10 times. Okay, yeah, we can, yeah, have a look, it's executed the same scenario 10 times. Total test count is 10, pass count is 10, fail count is 0. Okay, so we are executing the same scenario 10 times. Okay, so this is the invocation count. You can make it to any number. Okay, 10, 20, 5. So as per that number, your test case will be executed a number of times. Okay, so you can see the results from here. So here you are getting 10 test cases. Okay, 1 of 10, 2 of 10. Okay, so this is the feature of invocation count. You can run the same scenario multiple times. Okay, try this thing on your machine, and if you have any doubt, please ask me in the comment section. Okay, that's all for today. Thank you so much.